bloodthirster of khorne is back, and he's giving pain to all who comes in the way. Skulls for the skull throne. Yeah, what can I say? I found a new nice combo. These are the last days before the major updates, and yeah, I'm playing a lot of Kabanda at the moment. And you see it's okay, the win rate, we are close to high Terra, upper Terra, and it's quite fine. And yeah, I want to show some matches, for example, versus Perturable. And yeah, we changed a lot. We have the Priest of Old Faith, and the Priest of Old Faith are summoning the demons of Ruinstorm, and this is awesome. So what I find, that these priests will lower the cost of your demons in the hand, and yeah, this guy especially does not care about Runestone demon, another demon, doesn't matter, he will just lower them costs, which I love. Sadly, he managed to remove him. But this deck is quite fun. Yeah, yeah, we're going full damage versus him. And we all know that full damage is needed versus Perturable. Otherwise he was gonna kill us. Yeah. So I had a lot of problems make Kabanda work again, and now I would say he works really good. Yeah, I'm buffing my troop up here. Since the nerf of the Seeker of Sludge, which hit them the most because it was the only fast troop they had, they are really difficult. But now we see it's 28 to 16, even if 14 now. So I have to go full damage on him. Now it's getting interesting, he's using the viral bombs, but thanks to the survivor trait, the survivor bombs did not hit fully. And here we go. Healing, and now Krone's favor are perfect for Bloodthirster of khorne to use that thing, and we are fitting exactly. So thanks to the new combinations of the new cards, I would say, come on, let's look a little bit more before I show the deck. I would say he's really reliable again. This match was perfect here. Let's see that one. And I had really some struggles before that, and we see now the power of the Priest of Old Faith. Ashley Belt, yeah, you see already my hand is really full, and usually this is a big problem, but thanks to the Priest of Old Faith, I will get another Lucretia style here. You will see this is the same effect, and as long as he's on the board, this is like a demon Lucretia. Really funny. Should be also a thing to use Lucretia using that deck and put it full of demons. I think I just gonna try it. He's buffing, destroying. Yeah, blood letters. Yeah, like you see the card, the Lambada Thunder Hawk is doing annoying work studying the whole board. And the problem is when the Black Toads are stunned, I can't use them. Yeah, I misplayed. First, of course, you attack with blood letters. We'll buff everything in the hand here. Yeah. So the basic idea here, yeah, we speed up a little bit. Now we see it already again. Now I can't use my Pluck Toads, sadly, so we go on. void engagement. So we have one at least with two, this is okay. Orbital base, yeah, this is good for my board. Again, Exodus. So he's stealthing all the time. I can't use my board. This is a really trapped situation. But now should be over. The whole ring. Giving me awful 8 damage. But still, now it's my turn. And it's time for the Priest of Old Faith. I'm getting again Lucretia style on the board. So I can get rid of my cards here. So what can I do? I put all the Fel Reavers, and you see the combination is great. Look how many frontline troops I managed to put out one turn only because of the priest. Orbital Blaze. He's cleaning the board, but still can't kill it. And now it's my turn. Eternal Rivalry. And death to the traitor. Blood. Skulls for the skull thrones. That's what we want. Yeah, like you see, Jinata Crawl here. We played draw. Was also really good because of the stealth troop. Really nice match. I should show it also. The problem is by Crawl, she will really benefit to destroy your troops, so you can't use the toads. Strategic reserve. Also, one meta at the moment is strategic reserve, but the Runestone demons can really hold against them because they have awesome troops. Really difficult to remove for the stealth ones. Execution blade, so they get literally the same now. Clash of the Titans. Yeah, Eternal Rivalry. Sadly, I don't have any other options. And yeah, 27, 19. and I couldn't manage to take him down, sadly. In this case, I have to take the damage. And one reason why I couldn't make him down is this little guy here, K. And Unbreakable Focus, really random, but hit me hard. Sadly, I don't have any others. So I needed to get rid of our friend, the Duke. Yeah, this is a really, really big nerf that I don't have any fast troops anymore. Otherwise, this guy would be totally meta. Like this, he's still working good. Contrada, 7. Ooh. There were a close chance that I draw it again, then I win. And now I give him the 2 unspoiled land, I draw a card. Since this is precognition, yeah, I couldn't do anything wrong. I couldn't attack him, otherwise I would go for cleave 2. So the options are quite well. He was back to the red also. Good win. So let's see at the deck. So these are the key cards. Where are my friends? The Priest of Old Faith. Because the Priest of Old Faith will give cost your demons one less. And I didn't thought this would affect the Runestorm demons because they're like any. Thing I in my brain I thought somehow they are special demons and doesn't count in demons because also the cultists can't summon them, yeah, because they have also their own demons, but this really accounts for all demons, yeah. Yeah, Eternal Rivalry one time, the Crone's Favor, plus 4 is good, together with Eternal Rivalry is really nice. Warmaster Deceit, if Warmaster Deceit we can talk about, maybe also good would be that card, the Fracture in Time, since when you play versus Imperial Fists, the ward will be covered in troops, they cost a lot of energy, or versus Vulcan, to build the board up, to give them survival, because it gives them Bastion or something, and this is a good thing to set everything back, to reset that you can send the final blow. Yeah, so this is the first deck since the nerf, which really works for me, and yeah, especially with Kabanda, yeah. And I say, try it out yourself, bring skulls to the Skull Throne, and yeah, we have even here Azak, we have the Karepsi, there are more possibilities maybe to buff them. You can also think of more 4 and 5 energy troops, yeah. These troops I don't use even, this one here. If it had frontline, maybe it was okay, but like this is really bad. Even though it can cost one less, it's not that. Maybe I will do a Samus deck. Yeah. You see, play it, I didn't play it so much. Yeah. Didn't win more than 50. Played 1,000 match. Whoops. I didn't know that I played so much matches with that guy. Yeah, okay. So, skulls for the Skull Throne. Death to the False Emperor. Yeah, bring pain, my friends. Good night. Good fight, and get them.